find all anagrams in a string, right? See guys, in this question we have two strings, string S and string P, and we need to figure out what all anagrams do this string S have, right? What I mean to say is, see, if you guys can see, this is our string P which has element A, B, C, right? And this is our string S which has element like this, C, B, A, E, B, A, B, A, C, D, right? Now, we need to find the starting point of all the possible anagrams of string P which are present in string S, right? For example, see, if ABC, we need to find anagram for ABC, then see, this is one of its anagram, right? This is one of its anagram, CBA. We can rearrange CBA and we can make ABC, right? One more anagram which is present here is this BAC, right? This BAC. So, what we need to do is, we need to return or we need to print the initial or the first index of this anagram. So, for CBA, we need to print 0. For BAC, we need to print 6, right? So, this is what we need to do. Okay. Now, the thing is, how we solve this problem, right? Okay. To solve this problem, we will use two hash maps, right? So, this is our first hash map. This is, let's say, HMS and this is HMP, right? So, what will be our first step? Our first step will be create a frequency map for string P. So, this is our string P. So, its frequency map will be like this. Frequency of A is 1, frequency of B is 1, frequency of C is 1, right? So, this is our first step. Our first step is to create the frequency map for string P. Now what we will do, we will create two pointers. First pointer is starting pointer, which is initially equal to 0. And second pointer is end pointer, which is equal to initially p dot length minus 1. So, what is the p dot length in this case? In this test case, p dot length is 3. So, 3 minus 1, it should be 2. Okay. So, our starting pointer will be here and our end pointer will be here, right? Now, what we will do, we will add, for our second step will be to add all these elements which are present in between the starting pointer, including in fact the starting pointer and end pointer. So, what all the elements do we have including this starting and end pointer? This will be CBA. So, first what we need to do is we need to create the frequency map for this. So, our second step will be to create frequency map for this. So, it should be character, it should be integer, and it is again can character, it is integer, right? So, CBA, right? CBA. Now, by C, we have constructed these two hash maps, right? Now, what we will do, first, what we will check is these two hash maps are equal. So, see, size of this, both these hash map are equal, and its key value pairs are also same, C1, C1, B1, B1, A1, A1, right? Okay. So, if these two hash maps are equal, then what we can see, the starting pointer, that is this, the starting pointer we can make a anagram from this starting pointer. So, our first answer should be, in this case, test case should be 0, right? Because starting pointer initially had 0. Now, what we will do, we will increment our starting pointer and end pointer, right? So, we will increment our starting pointer and end pointer. So, now, our starting pointer will point to this, our ending pointer will point to this, right? Okay, so after incrementing this pointer, what you need to do is you need to update your HMS, right? Hash map for string s. So how you will update it? See, how you will update is you will update like this. You will remove the character which is present at s just before this starting pointer, and you will add the character which is now present at end pointer, right? What I mean to say is you have to delete this and you have to add this in your HMS, right? So once you do this, your first step, what will be your first step? Your first step will be remove this C. So your C is this. So you will decrement its frequency, so it should be 0. So if frequency is 0, then we will basically remove this key value pair. So our this step is clear. Now we need to add one element into our hash map. So we have to add which is present at end pointer, so it should be E. So E is not present, so we will create new key value pair, so it should be E1. Right. Now we will again compare, do these two hash maps are equal? See, size of both hash maps are same, but key value pair are not same. See, E1 is not present in HMP, right? So that's why we will not consider this starting pointer, right? We will not consider this starting pointer. Now we will again update our starting and end pointer, right? So we'll again update our starting and end pointer. So now our starting pointer will add to this, and our end pointer will add to point to this, right? Now what we will do, we will remove this and add this, right? We'll remove this and add this. So first of all, we'll decrement the frequency of B, so it should be 0. So if it is 0, so we'll remove this. We have removed key which is present just before the starting pointer. Now what we'll do, we'll add key which is present at end pointer, so it is again B. So B is not there, so what we'll do, we'll create a new key value pair which is equal to B1. Now we'll again check, do these two key value, these two hash maps are same? No, these two hash maps are not same. So we'll again update our starting and end pointer, right? Okay, so our end pointer will point to A and our starting pointer will point to E, right? See, we will do this step for all, we will do this step until our end pointer will reach to this, right? We will do this step. Once our end pointer will reach out of the array or out of this index of string s, we will stop there and we will finally print this array list or these numbers, right? So this is what the algorithm of this problem. You need to update your two pointers and compare these hash maps, right? Whenever the hash maps are equal, then you need to print or add that starting pointer, otherwise you need to continue, right? Okay, now let me quickly share the code of this problem, right? So code is here. So what we have is, we have a string s and string p, right? Now what we are doing, we are creating our starting pointer and end pointer, like I have showed you. Now, since the return type of this equation is a 1D integer array list, so our answer should be like, we have to create an array list or a list, and all the starting pointers should be added into this array list, and we need to return this, right? So for result, we are creating this list, right, called A and S answer, right? Now, see, if p dot length is greater than s dot length, right? Suppose the string p is abcd, right? And the string s is abc. Now, since the length of string p is greater than string s, then obviously, guys, we can't create any anagram of string p in string s, right? Because obviously, length of string s is smaller than length of string p, then we can't create anagrams because there are not sufficient character present in our string s. So in this case, we need to return our empty array list, right? Because we can say that there is no possible anagram, so we should return empty array list, right? If starting pointer is greater than end pointer, This should be not our case. So you can ignore this also. You can ignore this. Starting pointer can't be greater than this. Yeah, one thing can be the, yeah, you should not ignore this actually. See, there can be a test case called P is empty. P is an empty string and S is non-empty string like this. So end pointer in this case should be 0 minus 1, that is minus 1, and starting pointer should be 0. So 0 is obviously greater than minus 1. So in this case we should return also again a empty string, right? Okay, so that was the corner cases. Now I think we should need to come on our main algorithm, right? Let me change the size of this eraser. Okay, so this is clear. Now what we are doing, we are creating two hash maps, HMS and HMP, for our string S and string P. These are nothing but our frequency maps, right? Now what we are doing is we are creating frequency map for string P, right? We are creating frequency map of string P. Now what we are doing is we are creating frequency map for string S, but not complete string S. We will create frequency map for string S up till this end index, right? Up till this end pointer, right? So like here, initially what we did is we did our starting pointer was pointing to this. Let me erase this. And our ending pointer was pointing to this. So initially what we are doing, we are creating this HMS like this. C B, sorry, C B A. So this was our step, that step, right? We are creating our HMS from starting pointer to this initial end point, right? So this is what we are doing here, right? Now we are checking, do these two hash map HMS and HMP are equal? If these two hash maps are equal, then we will add this index of start pointer to our answer ANS R1D array list, right? Now what we will do, we will increment our starting pointer and end pointer, right? Okay, so once we have incremented our starting pointer and end pointer, now our next step is to do this for all the elements of our string S up till our end index is less than string dot S string dot length, right? The length of string S. Now so we'll come to this while loop. We'll do this operation until our E is less than S dot length. Now what we are doing here is, let me scroll it down. Yeah. Cool. Now see, what we are doing is we are adding keys for our new end pointer and we are removing keys for our previous starting pointer, not current. This was our current. We are adding key for our current end pointer and we are removing keys for our previous starting pointer, right? Since we are adding keys for our current E, then we will get the character of which we'll get the character which is present at index E in string S and store it in CH variable, and we'll add this key value pair in our HMS frequency map, right? Now what we'll do, we'll remove which is present. We will remove the key, or we will decrement the value of key of our previous starting pointer, right? So for previous starting pointer, what we are doing is we are not searching for starting pointer. We are searching for starting pointer minus one for previous character, right? That's why we are doing this st minus one, right? So if this previous starting pointer is present, of course it will be present. So we'll remove its frequency oh, sorry, will reduce its frequency by 1 if the frequency, its value by 1, of course. If its value will come 0, then we'll remove this key value pair, right? Now, after this adding or removing, what we need to do is we need to check, do this HMS and HMP are equal? If these two hash map are equal, then we'll add this starting pointer to our ANS array list, right? But if they are not, then we'll do nothing. We'll simply increment the value of our starting pointer and our end pointer, right? Now, we'll do this operation up till our end pointer is less than s dot length, right? Once it is greater than or equal to this s dot length, we will come out from this loop and we will simply return our answer array list, right? So this is it, guys. This is what the code of this problem.